Let's come to addition of fractions. We'll add fractions in three different cases. In the first case, we'll have like fractions and how to add like fractions. In the second case, we'll have unlike fractions. And in the third case, we'll have mixed fractions. Now let us see how to add fractions in these three different cases. Now when we have like fractions, for example, now here we have 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3, 1 by 3 and 2 by 3 are like fractions. So therefore in this case what we'll do is, we'll take 3 as the denominator and we'll add the numerators, 1 plus 2, that will give you 3 by 3, which is equal to 1. So in case of like fractions, you simply have to add the numerators and the denominators will remain as same. Let's come to unlike fractions. Now in case of unlike fractions, for example, if you have 1 by 3 plus 5 by 6. Here we see that 3 and 6 are different numbers, so we can see that these two fractions have different denominators. So in this case, what we'll do is, we'll find out the LCM of 3 and 6. If we find out the LCM of 3 and 6, we'll get 6 as the answer. So what we'll do is, we'll take 6. Now we'll see how many times 3 goes in 6. 3 goes 2 times in 6. So what we'll do is, we'll multiply the numerator with 2. This gives us 2 as the answer here. I repeat. First of all, you'll see how many times 3 goes in 6. You know that 3 goes 2 times in 6. So therefore, we'll multiply the numerator with that 2. We'll get 2 here. Now we'll see 6 goes 1 times in 6. So we'll multiply 5 with 1, we'll get 5 here. So ultimately, you get 7 by 6 as the answer, which can be converted into mixed fraction as 1 by 6. Suppose we have a mixed fraction. In case of mixed fraction, for example, suppose we have 1 by 2 plus 2 3 by 4. In this case, what we'll do is, we'll first change the mixed fractions into improper fractions. We'll multiply 2 with 1, 2 1s are 2, plus 1 gives you 3. Similarly, we'll multiply 4 with 2, 4 2s are 8, plus 3 gives you 11. Next, we'll find out the LCM of 2 and 4. LCM of 2 and 4 will give you 4. We'll write here 4. Now see, 2 goes 2 times in 4. So we'll multiply 3 with 2. We'll get 6. 4 goes 1 times in 4. So 1 into 11 will give you 11. I repeat, 2 goes 2 times in 4. So we'll multiply 2 with 3. We get 6. Similarly, 4 goes 1 time in 4. So we'll multiply 1 with 11. We get 11 here. So 6 plus 11 gives you 17 by 4, which can be written as 1 by 4 as the answer. So this is how we'll find out the addition of fractions. Here, when we have like fractions, we'll simply add the numerators, the denominator will be same. When we have unlike fractions, we'll first find out the LCM of the denominator and adjust the numerators accordingly, and then we'll find out the answer. Similarly, when we have mixed fractions, we'll first change them into improper fraction, then we'll follow the same process as we have done in 2. That is, we'll find out the LCM of the denominator and then accordingly adjust the numerator and we'll find out the answer. So this is how we'll add fractions. The similar method will follow in subtraction. In this case, what will happen is here you'll get minus and similarly you will find out the difference of the two numbers. Now let us come to multiplication of fractions. Now remember this when you want to multiply fractions. In order to multiply fractions, in that case product of fractions will be equal to product of numerators by product of denominators. Let us take an example. We have 1 by 2 one has to be multiplied with 3 by 4. So in this case what we'll do is we'll multiply the numerator. 1 into 3 gives you 3. 2 into 4 gives you 8 as the answer. So answer is 3 by 8. So this is how we'll multiply fractions. So we basically remember that product of fractions is equal to product of numerators and product of denominators. Now let us